Hi Deepak, welcome to Dialogue with Darwin.
Thank you
for joining us today. This is a series where we wanted to pick the mind of HR leaders in the industry to understand what are certain aspects of HR that have evolved over the years, right? And on that note, the first thing that we would want to ask you is, what do you think is one aspect of talent which organizations started approaching very differently now vis-a-vis the past?
So I think talent has been the most critical asset which the organization possessed. But I think the need to have the right talent specifically for the jobs that are designed today is emerging very differently. Also, the other aspect that comes when it is about scrutinizing or selecting the right talent is filtering out the ability to work in the real scenarios versus what you really bring on paper. The empirical data which is coming or is available with you because of various researches around personality, around the job fitment, person job match, etc., can be utilized now much more. And you have the control over that analysis in much better way, because it reduces your individual or human bias from, you know, selecting the person of your likes or dislikes. So if you have a system which can enable you to process all these informations in a timely manner, I think you can make much more informed decision to take the right candidate on board.
Since we talked about leveraging technology on that aspect, the next question that we wanted to ask you was, how do you think organizations' approach towards digitalization has changed over the years? What do you think is the major objective with which organizations are turning towards digitalization?
I think the biggest change which I've seen is around the experience side of it. Previously, it was about automating the manual processes. Now it is about enhancing the user experience or employee experience. How do you make it, something which is very, very user friendly? It's very similar to what the technologies or the other platforms that you use, example, your Facebook or Amazon or anything that is very easy to use for you.
What would be one advice that you would have for an organization that is going for digitalization now or is looking for a technology support?
Technology changes very fast. The expectations, or the, so to say, what we table as expectations today will become the reality. So can you think about technology requirement which will emerge after 2 to 3 years, given the kind of people you have or adding into or coming into your workforce? They're far more technology savvy. They understand tech much more than what you can, you know, really think of. So can you really plan something which will help you sustain for next 5 to 7 years? Or is it just that you bring one technology platform and think about changing it in next 2 years' time?
Right. Great. So now we want to know how you think you have changed personally as well. So on that note, what do you think is one thing that has changed a lot about you from the day you started your career to now?
I think the way I see things, the way I perceive people, it has changed a lot. I give a lot of time to myself in terms of processing that information and then coming to the judgment. Unlike the previous years, wherein, you know, you just see one thing or somebody and you just come to the conclusion or judgment.
So Deepak, on a personal front, we would love to know about you in the more instant way that we do today, which is the rapid fire way. If you can tell us, what is your favorite hangout place at work?
Beer.
What is one quality about a team member that you admire?
Sincerity.
Is there a movie that has truly inspired you and you would recommend the team members to watch?
There's a movie called The Walk.
Any resolutions for 2020?
Evolve more.
If you have to rename the function HR, what would you call it?
I would like to remove that word resource.
Okay.
So it's a human department.
What is one quality that you look for when you're hiring someone?
Learning agility.
Thank you so much, Deepak. That was a pleasure learning about you and learning from you. Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for watching.